And we are back. Welcome back to another vlog, guys. Hope you're having an awesome day. It feels good to pick up this camera again, begin to vlog, and give you guys something in the new year. I have so many cool videos. I literally have a whole week of main channel videos planned for you guys.
We got Julio from Pakistan.
What's going on, guys? How's it going?
Fucking energy.
So Julio and I are going out on a road trip today, driving all the way to the middle of nowhere
to go see Rennie.
I'm excited. I've never met Rennie.
Wait, you're getting paid to hold the camera, right?
I think so.
Okay, here you go.
Okay, here you go.
All right, there you go. Now my cameraman's doing his job.
Let's go.
So sometimes, like, when I'm filming and, like, you know, Moshi's helping me, or Julio, he's helping me film videos, but sometimes I have this, like, urge to just put Vaseline on my hands and hold my own camera because I'm so used to it. I've been doing it for 8 years, holding my own camera.
That's disgusting.
Hey. Anyways, the energy's in the air. We are about to go and see Rennie. You guys haven't seen Rennie in a while. And that's because, well, Rennie actually has a girlfriend. And ever since he... I can't even talk. Ever since he got a girlfriend, just went completely MIA. I miss him. Today's video is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends. Raid has prepared something special for all new players this Christmas. Get ready to celebrate the 12 days of Raid. Download Raid Shadow Legends from the links below, copy your player ID from in-game, and then go to 12daysofraid.plarium.com. Enter your player ID and then set out on a fun festive adventure that lasts 12 days, running from December 19th to January 10th. Each day, experience a new chapter in this wintry story, and play a new minigame for a chance to win some amazing in-game and real-life prizes, including holiday-themed Raid champions, which I love the most, and even Amazon gift cards worth up to $1,000. Existing Raid players, don't worry, you're not being left out. Head to 12daysofraid.plarium.com where you're gonna find a special code that everyone can use for a small festive gift. Raid's got something extra special happening now. They've released a special legendary champion based off of Ronda Rousey, the MMA fighter slash champion. That's pretty cool. Yes, you heard me right, the Ronda Rousey. Whether you're a new or existing player, you can get a free Ronda Rousey right now. All you gotta do is log in and play Raid for 7 days between now and February 20th, and Ronda is all yours. That is all there is to it. To celebrate Ronda's arrival in Raid, you can also use the special promo code RAIDRONDA to get a bunch of helpful stuff like a 3-day 100% XP boost, 500k silver, and 5 full energy refills. Perfect for levering your Ronda up so she's at the top of the game. Just enter promo code RAIDRONDA and all these goodies could be yours. I'm about to open up some really cool gifts in my inbox here, which is called the Shards. Shards are crystals that allows players to summon unique champions to their armies via the portal in your bastion. Shards come in different types, and each can drop champions of different degrees of rarity. Let's go ahead and open out the shards. No matter if the shards are good or bad, they're still gonna be useful for you in the game. If they're a good one, you can level them up and use them to your advantage. And if they're bad ones, you can sacrifice them to level up your good champion. Ooh, okay, here we go. We got the mystery shard over here. Summoning. What are we getting? Oh, War Boy. Holy crap, this guy looks cool. Look at his outfit. He's got an axe, he's got a skirt. And that's pretty much it. I like this dude. Go ahead and summon an ancient shard and see what we get from this one. Boom! Holy shit, these guys are crazy looking. We got the Flesh Eater, level 1, 3-star, but I'm absolutely digging all the blood on his arms. His mallet looks really deadly and scary. I bet this guy can really inflict some damage, and he's part of the Origin tribe, which is cool. Those are pretty cool. That's what you get from these charts. Sometimes you get these like epic champions, epic upgrades, and sometimes you get like little stuff, but they're all useful in this game. And if you haven't started playing Raid yet, click my link in the description below or scan the QR code that you're seeing on the screen during this entire video to get yourself a bonus of up to $30. We're talking a free epic champion, Shinobu, plus 200k silver, 1 XP boost, 1 energy refill, and 1 epic skill tome. All this treasure will be waiting for you right here in this inbox, available for 30 days for new players. And once you're in the game, come find me under the name of Mo Sargi, and if you're fast enough, you might be able to join my clan.
He just had his double, triple, times tax espresso, and...
You know what's funny?
Huh?
This costs about $5, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I have an espresso machine at home, and I have an ice machine at home. I could literally make this at home, but I choose not to. Do you know why?
Why?
Honestly, I don't know. We're all just brain dead at this point in this life.
Yeah.
I just hope an asteroid just blows up this whole planet and we all just die eventually.
Onwards.
All right, so we haven't seen Rennie in a very, very long time, and we're about to go pay him a visit at work. This should be funny.
How are you?
Good, man.
Good to see you, bro.
Wow, you're getting desperate for content.
We're here to
a little bit depressing. This is what you're lowering yourself to?
We're here to break your walls of it, because we haven't seen you in like 6 months.
I know.
What's going on, man?
Moshi, right?
My name's Moshi.
I've never actually met you.
I know.
You've never met? No, I've never met him in person.
That's Julio.
Julio.
Oh, from Pakistan.
From Pakistan, yeah.
Did you see Moshi?
No, that's
no,
Julio.
Julio.
That's Julio. So who's Moshi?
I don't know. Who's Moshi?
I don't know where you got that name from.
Yo, check out these boots. I just need them. I don't know why. We're getting boots.
Great content.
That's Rennie's girlfriend, by the way.
Hi, Rennie's girlfriend.
Hello.
You work with your girlfriend. How does that feel? Why do you think I'm still here? Like, she's the only reason I still work here. Well, they're gonna fire his ass. When they...
Hey, Marks. I've known you for a very long time, mm-hmm. And I just want you to know. Oh, can you tie these for me? What am I paying you for?
Tie my boots.
Okay, I'm holding camera.
I used to be his camera person. I want
to. Yeah, I have to go this.
Are you ready for what's gonna happen in the near future? You guys don't know this. I'm not even gonna tell them. I shouldn't tell them about what we're doing soon. Oh,
no,
that's
can't.
A big surprise.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, I'm just gonna blur what I just said. Also, the music in here is very loud, bad for copyright.
Are you sure these are the ones that I told you about? They look different.
No, those are the ones, bro. I told Reddy I want shoes, like for the forest and stuff, right? Because, you know, there's deep snow. But I don't know, man. Are you guys allowed to be doing this?
I'm doing on what? Break, thank you.
Oh, you're on break?
Yeah.
What do you need a break for? You guys barely work. I don't know how to tie shoes, apparently.
Wait, these are weird. Wow. Oh, you just
I've
do this.
Children tie boots faster than this guy here. I know you're special, Mo, but come on.
Bro, my mom tells me I'm special all the time.
You're almost there.
Wait, how do you...
There you go. Rennie guarantees that I will not slip on ice with these boots. He said it. You said it. Say it.
That's right. 100%. Like, he's not going to break his neck. If anyone's going to break your neck, Mo, it's going to be me. Okay?
You know what we're doing after when we leave?
What?
We're going to go find some ice. And we're going to test them out. So if I break my neck today, it's Rennie's fault and Mark's. They're getting sued. Film, we're getting some good soft cores.
Oh my god.
Guys, look how cute this is. We used to cuddle.
We did.
This is not even fair.
I kind of miss it, to be fair. Like, Jay, I'm you sorry, but you're always like, it's gonna be second.
Good. Huh?
Boom. All right, we're going home. She's shocked. But Rennie's prone to accidents and getting injured. I had a concussion again. Last time we were out together, we were filming a video, he hurt his nuts. He was out for a month. And the worst part about that is I formatted the video and it had no footage.
I know. Thank you for that.
I formatted the video accident. It was a good video.
So much effort.
Yep.
So much pain.
Yep.
Literally. I think my voice is like one octave higher ever since we did that video together.
Every time he's wounded, that's why I bought you insurance.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, I'll need it.
We're doing something in the near future, something really big. Within the next couple of weeks, I have to buy insurance just for Rennie.
A liability, I'm sorry.
He's also a liability.
Moshi, we're gonna be perfect together. We can't swim. We're both prone to accidents.
Who's Moshi?
It's Julio.
Julio.
All right, Julio, you wanna go? I'm getting hungry.
To where?
I don't know, to be honest. We have no content for today's vlog.
The fact that you're even filming here is what's
dude, I'm really here just for content and like boots, which I'm not gonna pay for. Thanks to Rennie, he gave them to me for free.
Wow. Shout out to Rennie, guys.
Now it's fired 3 days later.
3 days later, Rennie's gonna call me, ask me for a job.
Go ahead, talk to the thing.
Oh my god.
What's the gun with it?
No, I missed you. Oh, that was so cool to see Rennie and his girlfriend. She's the reason why I don't see Rennie anymore, by the way. So hate down below, guys. I still gotta pay for it. I literally just walked out of Mark's. I didn't even pay for it. But these are gonna be really cool for the snow. Like, they're comfortable, they're lightweight. I haven't been into the forest recently because I need proper boots. Like, if my feet are wet, those are my boots.
That's disturbing. Wow, look at you. What the no?
Trying to do something funny, but I slipped.
Oh my god. Looks like you need insurance.
Put your sock, bro. Bro, I'm gonna stab you. Put your socks on.
Bro, you're about to get your ass fired.
He just showed me his feet.
No. Bro, my wife sees.
Dude, how are your feet so hairy and nasty? Fuck.
Shadi, I'm so sorry.
Bro, were you like half werewolf at one point in time? Are you actually recording this?
No, I'm not.
Okay, I thought you were. Do you want me to stroke you?
Please.
Okay. I'm not recording, are you?
I am.
You are in for a real treat. As you can see behind me, we're back to my abandoned house. It's been a long time since we've been here. Now, a few days ago, we came through here to check on things because it has been about a month and a half since I've been back, ever since the whole Steve the Clown incident. And you guys know I created this giant Ouija board in here, and I really want to be able to like do some like haunted stuff in here. We all know that I took Tom's brick from his actual abandoned house after it burnt down and then put it in this house. So this house has been priming. It's been priming with paranormal, but we did discover something really creepy the last time we walked through here, which I posted on my vlog channel. Someone had done a ritual in here while I was gone. There was candles in here. So someone has done something. I don't know if they summoned something evil. I don't know if there's entities in my house right now, but we're gonna be going inside and doing a video tonight. Later tonight, not right now. First we're gonna go and check on the trails. I haven't been through here in a while. I don't know if there's gonna be any activity from the clown guys or the homeless guys. Hopefully not. Really scared about this, and I'm really hoping we are gonna be safe filming in here tonight. One of the main reasons why we haven't been here since I've been back from the US is that the snow was like super deep here and we couldn't get in. The whole driveway was all blocked off. So we just unblocked it today and we basically are now able to come back and film haunted videos. Smash the like button, Timo Sargi merch in the links below. Let's get on with this.
We caught a lucky break, guys. The snow started melting. It allowed us to come back to the abandoned house, which is pretty good. I mean, I could always hire like a plow to come and plow the driveway, but
it was a big driveway and it's gonna cost a lot of money. So that's a no bueno. What I'm gonna do right now is just go and check on the trail up to the river. Make sure the homeless guys haven't been back. Like, we'd be able to see footprints if they have been. If not, we're gonna go inside. That's gonna give us the cue that it is safe. Now, recently I went to a haunted tunnel, the Blue Ghost Tunnel, and the homie followed me. I don't know if it was him or if it was somebody else, but I haven't been able to confirm who it is just yet. But something tells me in the future I will be able to confirm it.
But let's go and check on the trail and see if we can find anything there.
Whoa, what are these? These are really big prints. I think this could be a moose.
Oh my goodness.
Like actual moose.
Are they friendly mooses or?
Moose are territorial, and if they see us, they're gonna fuck us up.
Oh man.
Dude, look, they keep going. Or it could be, no, it's definitely not the homeless guy, because these aren't human prints. Right? Like, look at our shoes compared to wolves. These have big hooks.
Yeah.
Could be coyotes too. I don't see any deer poop anywhere. Well, we got a tree that's fallen over there. Wow, that's new. This is why I'm checking on the trail, you guys. Holy crap, dude, that's crazy. This tree was not here before. Well, it looks like I got some work in the summertime to get rid of this thing.
Yo, it keeps going, look.
It's a big forest, man. I'm sure we're gonna find a lot of surprises through here. Man, it feels good to be back here, not gonna lie. Like, it's been a while.
It's kind of scary, dude.
Yeah, so we're gonna make it past to the river, see if anything's changed in there. I'm gonna go back quickly to where the campsite was for the clowns, the one that they had by the river. I'm gonna see if it's still there or if anything's changed since I've left. Like, it's been a long time since I've been here. If everything's all good, if it's still the same, we're gonna come back to the house later on tonight once it gets darker, like at midnight, because we're gonna be doing a very, very creepy ritual that I've never done before, but I've always wanted to do it. So let's go and check on that campsite. Whatever these prints were, they're taking my shortcut. I got like a shortcut going on here. So some animals, whatever, I think it might be a moose. Cause look at the prints right behind you.
Yeah.
They're all over the place.
Oh, watch out. Be careful.
What the hell was that? Yo, I just seen a light back there.
Really?
Yeah, like coming from the actual house. I seen a light there. Is that, I don't think that, no, not, that wasn't what I saw. What I saw was much bigger, like someone's got a flashlight.
Oh my goodness.
What the f***?
In the abandoned spot?
Well, the abandoned, look, my abandoned house is directly right there. You know?
Yeah.
What is that light though?
What is that?
I don't know, but I'm kind of freaked out right now. Could be a street light or something that we're just seeing through the bushes.
Yo, do you hear
that? Yeah, I hear that. That's a dog. Dude, anytime the homeless guys were around, their dog was barking. They got a dog with them.
Sounds like multiple dogs.
Could be coyotes, too. Every time I come here, something happens. I just want to make it to the campsite and see if it's there. Let's go, come on.
So I'm still following these tracks going into the deep forest. Damn, it feels good to be back here. I miss this place, guys. Although I had a lot of like trauma and PTSD and bad things that went wrong here, I still miss it. Whoa, what the hell? Dude, this tree somehow broke. This big ass tree was not broken before.
And it broke from the bottom.
Yeah, look at this.
It's so weird.
How the hell did that happen? No, don't push it. Dude, what the f-? This is what I mean, like so much shit can go wrong.
That wasn't here before?
No, this tree was standing tall. Like I would shoot archery from here. See, look, I would aim my archery right down through here. How did that fall? That is crazy. It looks like something chewed it. Okay, let's go to the campsite. We're losing daylight. Let's go.
Yeah. These prints or whatever, they go towards the campsite. The one that I destroyed. So I caught, you don't know this, but I caught these guys living on my property, like right by the river. They had two campsites, one deep in the forest, like 20 minutes walk, and one right here by the river.
Wow.
Look, something's been coming in and out of here. That's crazy.
Do you think they're back there again?
Well, if they are, then you gotta start running, but these are animal prints. These are animal hooves.
And you said they're territorial, right? So
I'm not worried about moose. I'm worried about the homeless guys.
Whoa, what's that?
This is where they had a camp.
What does it say?
Or die. This is like where their camp is. Okay. So, this is a good sign. They never came back and they never made a new campsite. Look, their tent is still buried underneath all that snow.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they had like all these like weird things here. They even had a path. They created some type of ditch that goes deep in that way. and that circles back to the house. So that's how they were getting to me quickly back then. So anyways, this video isn't supposed to be about these homeless guys that were living in my forest, but I did want to come and make sure it was safe for us to film here tonight, because we're going to be here all night long. So like the whole challenge that we're doing here tonight, it's called the Dry Bones Challenge. Never done it before. You guys have requested it. If there are other rituals that you guys want me to do, let me know in the comments below. But basically, we need to be filming at 12 o'clock midnight for this challenge to work, and we cannot leave the house until 3 o'clock in the morning. So it's going to be a long night. It's going to be very terrifying once we come back here and do this challenge. Sargi family, what the f*** just happened to us? It is 3 o'clock in the morning right now. We just finished filming a main channel video in here and all hell broke loose in the abandoned house. You guys remember we came through here the other day and these candles were here. Someone had done a ritual. I guess someone had summoned something into here. We were doing a ritual of our own called the dry bones game or whatever. I don't remember what the f*** it's called. Look at my rocking chair, it's broken. Mm-hmm. All hell broke loose in here.
Yeah, well, you broke it, Mo.
Oh my god, dude.
You just don't remember.
Crazy. I'm injured too. Like, my arm hurts, my back hurts, everything fucking hurts. And I don't even, the worst part about it, dude, is I don't remember a fucking thing happening. Like, I really don't.
Yeah, it was really scary, man. You were on the floor right here. I don't know if you remember.
I don't remember that.
Wow.
I honestly don't remember a thing. I just remember being in front of the candles last, which, by the way, we didn't even light these candles.
Mm-hmm.
This is crazy. I want to get the hell out of here, but I also wanted to stay at the same time. I don't want to go back upstairs. There's a lot of destruction up there.
Yeah.
Guys, I'm telling you, all hell broke loose in this place today.
Even the basement, it's full of water.
It's flooded, yeah.
Yeah.
Because of the snow melting.
Bad signs everywhere.
Why do we do this, dude? I feel bad because the whole upstairs is just destroyed now.
Yeah.
Did I just hear something walking? I was going to give the Sargi family a vlog in here today, but it's 3 o'clock right now. It's late. I'm injured. I don't feel good. I just had like a demon rip through me, like literally. Hey, demon, are you still here? Bro, my heart's beating so hard right now. Dude, the worst part about tonight from what I remember, I don't know what you got on camera.
Mm-hmm.
That candle behind you just went up 3 feet high in flame and it went back down. Oh my god, I think he's still here. So the worst part from what I remember is being grabbed in the back and it just felt like it never let go. And after that, I don't remember much. Oh my god, what a crazy fucking night. I really wanted to give you guys a really big vlog here today, but what do you think, bro?
I think we should just head out, man, and come back here tomorrow. Refresh, clear-minded.
We're planning on coming back for the main channel tomorrow to see what kind of demon or who this demon was. It might get dangerous if we summon him back, but I'm going to be doing just that. We have to get a new mirror because the mirror is destroyed now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, dude, let's get out of here.
Let's get out of here.